Hey, what's up? It's Rich at RMAutodiag here, and today we're going to have a look at testing some relays. Hey, just before I start, I'd like to just give a quick shout out to any of my new subscribers. Just a big thank you. And if you're not already subscribed, click the subscribe button, hit the bell for notifications. Okay, let's get started. Okay, first, four pin relays, standard in most vehicles. They might come in a few different shapes and sizes, like you can see here. They all work the same, so we're just going to go through a few quick tests. Now I don't know if you can see on this one, if I get the light, they've usually got a little diagram showing what's going on inside of them. And this one might be a bit easier to see. So what we've got here is you've got the switch side, and you can see the little symbol for a switch up the top, just up there. And let's get something pointy. So we've got a switch symbol up here, and that's normally open. And then down here you've got another circuit, which is what the coil side of it, the control side of it, which makes the switch work. So common sort of terminals on these is you do have 30 and 87 together, and 85 and 86 together. So if you look on the side of the board, it's on the side on here, shows you the terminals 86 and 85, and you've got terminal 30 and 87 here. So you tend to find whatever is being powered by the relay is going to be on the larger two of the terminals. I don't know if you can see on the side here the size of that compared to those terminals there, slightly bigger. So what we should have is these two should be connected and these two shouldn't be until the relay is energized. So what we're going to do is a quick check is if we turn the multimeter on, and we've got it set up to ohms, which is that little omega symbol there. I think you can see that there. So we'll check our leads quickly. We put them together. 0 ohms. And what we're going to do is if we just go on each side of the terminal, we can check that there's something going on there. And there we go. We've got 117 ohms, nearly 118 ohms. So we know that the coil inside of that is intact and working. So we shouldn't have any continuity to any of the other terminals. So, oh well. And the other one is, oh well. And if we go between these two, we also shouldn't have anything here, because the switch isn't closed yet. Right, next thing I'm going to do is, what we're going to do is we're going to get some power. So I've got set up a little battery pack. Obviously you can do this just on the normal car battery. So we've got two terminals here, just a positive and a negative on a 12 volt feed, as I say, off a battery pack. And what should happen is on this circuit here, the 85 and 86, when we complete that circuit with a power and a ground, that should pull the switch down and we should hear a click. So as you can see, we've got the 86 and 85 there. So if we connect up a positive and then a negative, we should hear a click and off. Most people stop there, but we can take it a little bit further. What we're going to do is we're going to leave the multimeter on ohms, and I'm going to connect these two up, and we're going to see exactly what's going on when we connect these up. So if we put power to the relay there, and as soon as we complete the circuit, what we should see on the meter is it should change to 0 ohms or pretty close to it. And there we go. So we're on 0 ohms. We've got a connection. As soon as I take that off, it should go OL. There we go. So we can be pretty happy that that relay works. And it's good to be on the car. I think really anything higher than an ohm of resistance, and you're going to have to start thinking about the contact inside of there has got some trouble. We can do the same on another relay. Same setup, slightly smaller, a bit bigger, than the other one. It should work exactly the same. So what we need is we need our 85 and 86, and let's see if we can see on the bottom. Okay, so the 85 and 86 is the lighter coloured terminals, and we can be 100% on that. Make sure they are the ones that are connected together. And yeah, we've got some resistance through that, about 70 ohms on this one. Okay, so if we go across the other two, we shouldn't see anything. And then we're going to connect up our positive again, and we'll touch on the negative. You should hear a click, and we should go to about 0 ohms. So that was the click. 0 ohms, 0.1 of an ohm, 0.2. Again, pretty good. So that is the basics of testing on there on a relay, and we can make sure that that switch is opening and closing. If you had an issue with it and you had the click, it would just stay OL on the meter, and you would know that even though you had a click, nothing was connecting inside. So you've probably got a bad contact points on the switch inside of there. Okay, just as a bit of a bit of bonus footage here. This is what the relay looks like when it's open. That's the big coil that energizes, and the switch is just here. I don't know if you can see, if I push it, you can see it contacting there, and contact points are just in here. What we can do is we can set it up and we can see it working as well. So what I'll do is we'll get everything set up again. So what have we got here? Can't see anything. So if we set that one up, we should, if I can get it in the middle of the screen, should see this close. See it moving in and out there? Sorry, it's a bit blurry. And that's the part that's contacting. So it's always nice to see inside what's going on. But if you do have an issue with high resistance, it's usually going to be because those contact points have burnt. Okay, so hope you found that informative. Thanks for watching again, and don't forget to subscribe. Chuck a few comments down below if you want to start talking about any of this, and smash the like button, that'd be great. Thanks for watching. Cheers.